our senior economics reporter, Steve Liesman, with more on today's ADP numbers. Steve.
Yeah, Jonathan, only a slight decline in the ADP number that even the folks who put it out acknowledge doesn't tell the real story of what's going on in the job market and the real pain being experienced there through layoffs. But it does provide some information of the way things might go. So let me provide you with the data here and see what we're looking for in the days and weeks ahead here. Just down 27,000. And that was against an estimate of 125,000. February revised down just a little bit. But the weekly jobless claim number expected tomorrow, 3.1 million. That compares pretty closely with what we had last week. Non-farm payrolls also expected just to decline by 10,000. So what's the story? What's going on here? Well, first I want to show you the decline in ADP by business size. What's interesting about this is it's probably leading the way for how we're going to be losing workers here. Small business down by 90,000, well ahead of what's happening in medium and large side business. And you'd expect that. You'd expect that small business would be the first to shed workers, and large businesses have the capacity and the ability to hold on to the workers maybe a little bit longer. Looking by industry, you can see there's been a huge increase in education. Almost certainly that's health services there, up by 48,000. That could be, unfortunately, one of the saving graces of the economy here. And you can see the trade and transport that has the retail trade in it right there, down by 37,000. Leisure hospitality down by 11. Worst to come there almost for sure. So why does this data lag? Pretty easy to explain. The survey week for both the ADP and the jobs report on Friday is a week earlier than it really hit the economy. In ADP, you're going to be counted as unemployed even if you're not paid. And the BLS is going to count any work done during the week, even if you're laid off later. A better indicator of what's going on here is probably going to be in the jobless claims numbers. Let me show you a little bit about what's happening right there. 3.2 million last week, 3.1 million expected this week. That combination of 6 million is close to what we had in continuing claims during the worst part of the financial crisis. We just got there much more quickly, with the question being, would it be bigger? We'll see the number tomorrow if the states could process it more. So, guys, it's going to be three phases to this crisis when it comes to economic data. At first, the reality is going to be much worse than it looks like in the data. That's pretty much where we are now. And then the data is going to look about as bad as it is on the ground. And finally, you're going to get this improvement, and the data will probably lag it. We'll all be looking forward to that third phase.